The experiment is single phase voltage regulator or voltage control. The main function of this voltage regulator is it converts the fixed AC to the variable AC. In many of the applications, we need the variable AC, but the supplied AC is a fixed one, that is 230 volt. So to convert from fixed AC to variable AC, we'll use the triac arrangement. That is nothing but we are connect two SCRs in the anti-parallel configuration, that is T1 and T2 connected in an anti-parallel. So this configuration is connected to the load and returned to the supply. This is the circuit diagram. Now we'll see the output waveform. So our supply is fixed AC supply, that is 230 volt. This is a fixed supply, 0 pi 2 pi. So output voltage is how it works. During positive half cycle, this T1 gets forward biased, but it will conduct when the gate of this SCR is triggered. Suppose I will trigger this T1 at alpha. So from alpha, this T1 conducts and output waveform will be like this. So during negative half cycle, T1 gets reverse biased and T2 gets forward biased, but T2 starts conducting from pi plus alpha. From here, the negative half cycle starts conducting. During positive half cycle, the current flows through T1 through the load and back to the supply. During negative half cycle, the current flows reverse through the load first and through T2 and back to the supply. Here, current direction supports it in both the half cycle. That's why we are getting alternating current in the output waveform. So this is the output waveform of the single phase voltage regulator. Now we'll perform the experiment on this. So required apparatus for this experiment are AC voltage regulator trainer kit and one resistor load, voltmeter to measure the output voltage, and CRO to observe the output waveforms. Now in this kit, this circuit indicates even voltage regulator circuit in which the two SCRs are connected in anti-parallel and this configuration is connected to the load. So to control these SCR1 and SCR2, we need to give the gate signal. Those gate signals are generated by UJT triggering circuit. This UJT triggering circuit generates the two signals, that is G1 and G2. With the help of this, we can control the alpha. Here, with this knob, we can control the alpha. So now we'll see the connection. So this G1 generated signal is given to the gate of the T1, and G2 is given to the gate of T2. And across load, I will connect the resistive load. To observe the output voltage across this, I will connect multimeter across the load. And to observe the output voltage across this, I will connect the CRO. So now our connection is done. Now we will see the output waveforms. Now at the first alpha, our output required output waveform is like this. So during positive half cycle, first positive half cycle started from alpha and positive half cycle is completed, and it will the T2 wait for again pi plus alpha and negative half cycle conduct. This is the now value of alpha. For this value of alpha, the output voltage is 32.4 and brightness of the lamp is also high. Now we will increase the alpha with the help of this knob. You can observe the changes in the waveform when I increase the alpha. So when I increase the alpha, this area increases. For this alpha, the output voltage is reduced to 18.7 and brightness of the lamp is also reduced. So in this way, With the help of this knob, I can again increase the alpha. So in waveform, we can observe the alpha is increased, only some part of the output voltage is appearing here. So output voltage for this is 8.1 and brightness of the lamp is reduced to minimum. So in this way, we can get the variable output.